Well, guys, this is wrapping up the first evening here in Utah for our mule deer hunt, and honestly, it was pretty uneventful, especially compared to this morning. You know, this morning we saw a bunch of big bucks and a few really good ones we were going to try to hunt. We just unfortunately lost them in the sagebrush, and they bedded down somewhere. We couldn't get the exact location, so we thought we'd come back tonight and find them, and they'd stand up, and we'd put a stalk on, but they just never did. So we're not sure what happened. Maybe they got bumped during the middle of the day. Who knows? But either way, we're going to come right back here in the morning, and we're going after one of those three big giants that we saw. And if I had my pick, I'd get a chance at that wide one. We call him Whitey, similar to like a white tail and a wide buck, because he's super wide and he's got one side that's just like a white tail. So if I can get a shot at that buck in velvet, it would be the widest deer I've ever killed and my first velvet buck. So that deer has definitely grown on me, and I'm really hoping I get a chance at him. So we're gonna go head back to camp, grab some dinner and get some sleep, and then be right back here in daylight. So we'll see you in the morning. Incredible. So guys, we got here on the hill this morning, same spot that we sat last night and yesterday morning, and we've been looking for one particular deer. He's super, super wide, and that we call Whitey, and Kenny just found him, so we're super excited. We got our target buck found. This is a big deal. Oh boy, big mule deer spotted here in Utah. I've wanted to hunt here for so many years. Sarah came here a few years back, and I learned about this ranch. I've always wanted to hunt here ever since, and I was lucky enough to get one of the tags this year, so I'm gonna make it count. We prepared really hard for this hunt, and it's all come together because we got two monsters sitting on that hillside, and if I could shoot either one of them, I'd be super happy. So we'll just see kind of how it plays out. And I may just get my northern Utah mule deer. Putting the plan together. Man. So what we have to do is get up and I think around them and come in over top. So we got ourselves a hike today, but it's going to be worth it, I think, because we get up into this third draw, we'll get eyes on them, and then try to circle up and around, come in over top, and we're gonna be in good shape, because we can see there's no deer above them, and they're the highest deer, where there's a lot of deer sprinkled out right below them, which would make getting in close to them without bumping these other deer really hard. So we got ourselves a game plan, and we're gonna make it happen. Well guys, we just made it to the third gut here. We're gonna head up and hopefully get eyes on that buck. So we're gonna get up to those rocks that you see right there and start glassing. So let the hike begin. First section of rocks. I'm gonna peek over, make sure we can't see him or do see him. But stay out of sight, so. Alright. We're looking good. We're still one ridge over from where they are based on my Onyx map, so we're gonna make it to the next ridge and glass down, see if we see them. If not, we're gonna go circle high. The wind's still sucking down right now from the thermal, so we need to wait till it's later in the morning anyway for the thermals to start sucking up. So we got about a couple miles at least to get up and around them, but we're gonna keep moving. Based on the Onyx map and everything, we should be right above the deer. And we're gonna go over this edge and find the dirt patch, find the white rock, and then deer are right below the white rock. So, at least they should be. So we're in a good spot. Somewhere along this brim right here, there's a white rock, so I would assume that that white rock is like right there. And then they're 60 yards below the white rock. So we've got to get to that white rock, but it's got to be quiet. I got LTE service up here, which is pretty cool. I'm going to check the wind and see if the wind is going to pick up as the day goes on. We may have to camp out a little further. So we're getting really close to this ridge right here. As you can kind of see, it drops off. Now where we left the deer were just kind of milling around for like 25 minutes. So they're gonna be bedded somewhere really close. And we are right in between us and where we were spotting earlier this afternoon. So based on that, the deer should be just below us on that ridge. So they're gonna be really close, like within 100 yards. So this calm conditions, if he's within 100, I'm gonna shoot. Let's hope we get close. I hope he's 20 yards. Let's see what happens. Within 150 yards. It's time to get serious. Dropped our packs. Putting on the release. Everything seems to be working. Thank you.
got him. He's 94, guys. I drilled him. I got eyes on him. That was Whitey. Shot felt really good. Still got eyes on him. I got him. He's gushing, guys. 94 yards. It looks like a perfect shot. Go down, baby. Go down. He just went into this patch of the sagebrush, really. It's just the thick patch of it, and he hasn't came out. So we're pretty sure he went down. I mean, I cannot believe that. I mean, we were right here, everything's ready. I don't know what happened, but they spooked, and I went to adjust my sight, and it was completely frozen. You guys could see it. It wouldn't move. This gear broke, and this sight is falling apart. And I tried to super glue the pin on the sight here last night, and I made sure I didn't get any in the gears. But I think something must have leaked into the gear and froze it up. And I had to bang my sight loose, and I finally got it loose, and they stopped out there. He was at 95 because he took another step. But at that distance, I always hold for 1 yard lower because they're gonna drop when they hear the arrow. And everything felt great when it cut loose. And I think the wind was slightly, at the time, you know, blowing a little bit left, and I got a little bit left arrow drift, maybe a few inches, because I held right on the crease. And it blasted his shoulder, and that's why I shoot, you know, 82 pounds and a big sever, because that makes a big difference for shots like that. Those marginal hits where I hit him in the shoulder, but I'm pretty sure I got all the way through there. I mean, that shoulder's completely broken, and his blood is going everywhere, and he hasn't came out of that patch right there, so I'm pretty sure he's down. It's 9:30, and we're gonna give him about an hour and sneak in there and see if we can't get eyes on him. But guys, I just shot my northern Utah mule deer, baby, at 95 yards with my Hoyt. Well, we saw him go down in the bushes. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna circle up, get high, and scan those bushes and see if we can see him laying in there dead. So it's only been, you know, 20, 30 minutes, hasn't been very long. But we're gonna sneak high and stay out and then just kind of work our way in and go get my mule deer. So we just want to make sure he's totally dead and down. Here we go. So yeah, he ran where I shot him, you know, he ran bedded up into this bush, and I didn't want to wait all day and let him die. I wasn't sure. And so when we snuck up here and we saw him laying there, his head was down. And so I shot him again. I got a second shot. And he didn't even get up out of his bed. So that tells me that he was already dead. First shot was lethal. But either way, we got my mule deer, and we're gonna go get my hands on him. Jamie Christmas. He's done. I'm gonna pull him out here. Oh, wow. Look at this giant deer. That is incredible. I've never shot a deer this wide. I mean, that is just crazy. This is our number one target buck that we've been trying to go after ever since we've seen him here. He just had tons of mass. I mean, giant. I don't want to touch the velvet a lot because I don't want to ruin it, but let me get my bow over here. Man, guys, look at that. He is an absolute monster. What a cool buck anywhere. And he's got huge bases and brows, big. I mean, look how massive his tines are. Wow. I've never shot a velvet buck, so this is like super cool for me. Wow. Just look at that thing's width. He's just super cool. You know, it's, I had a lot of issues with my bow. I couldn't believe it. You know, I see him, he stops at 80, and I had my shot, and I was like, yes, and I went to crank my sight, and my sight was broken. The gear was messed up in it, and I couldn't figure out what the heck was going on. I couldn't get it to move, so I'm like jacking with it, trying to get it to go, and they just keep trotting out further and further, and he stops at 95, and I crank my sight to 94, and because I figured at that distance, he's not gonna hear the bow go off, but he'll hear that arrow coming. And he'll drop a little, and so that's exactly what we prepared for. And I cut loose, and the wind was kind of a little bit of a crosswind. I didn't quite register that. That was an error in my fault, and it drifted about 6 inches left, and I hit him in the shoulder. But shooting 82 pounds with those micro diameter EASTON PRO COMPs and a big, huge 2.1 sever, you know, it broke through the shoulder and got something good. I think I got one lung because we watched him go down and he stayed down, and I snuck in and got another shot just because I didn't want to wait, you know, and wait him out and wait 5-6 hours or whatever. And so we waited about 30 minutes and 40 minutes, maybe 30 or 40, I don't know, but and snuck in. I knew right where he was bedded down by this big bush, and I could see him. I shot him again right through both lungs. And he didn't even get out of his bed, you know, so he lifted his head up like this and then went back down. So he was already, you know, heading out, but couldn't be happier. I mean, this is awesome. You know, Sarah and I came out here, and it's been a dream of mine to hunt this ranch in northern Utah. It's a huge cattle ranch. I mean, 10,000 plus cattle on here and 250,000 acres. And it's been a dream of mine for about 40 years and to get a tag like this and shoot just an absolute giant buck like this. It's super cool. Not a typical mule deer, you know, it's just got a unique side and crazy wide. Super excited. Well, we're gonna grab some photos, and we're gonna have to pack him out of here. You know, where this cattle ranch has a lot of roads that run through it, so usually, you know, we can get a vehicle to it, but I don't think we're gonna be able to. So this deer is an old deer, he's super heavy. We'll drag him out, carry him out, whatever we got to do, and take it back to camp.